Hey guys, welcome back for another video review, and today be a real treat for all you Legend of Zelda fans. I have bought myself the Legend of the Hero massive tome book. This is only a release in the USA, and if you want this you'd have to get this imported, and I bought it from a shop called Fangamer, which I'll leave you guys a link down below. Basically this is their like leaflet here. If you guys want to check it out, it's I'll give you the what do you call it, it's basically www.fangamer.com, and if you guys want to check out the Facebook page and Twitter account, that's fine. But basically these guys do anime and game stuff, mainly game stuff related, so it is really cool. And they from a UK buyer, they actually ship rather really quickly, and they actually try and help us not get charged with the custom fees, which we keep getting smacked on. So yeah, we've got these awesome things from Fangamer here. So yeah, there's two versions of this book. You have the soft cover and the hardback edition. I bought the special first edition hardback one, which is the most expensive one. I believe it cost me around $35 in total. That's without the postage, and I paid another $25 on top of that for postage just to get it here quicker. And basically what this book is about is basically a field guide to Kanto. It's basically a massive tome and print, result of the year, and intense illustrations, studies and writings by the brilliant Kari Fry, which actually signed a piece of this, which I'll show you guys soon what you get with this book, the hardback version. Basically, the difference between the hardback and the normal version is you get a foil stamped leather cover, which is inside, which I'll show you guys soon. You get a dust jacket cover, which doubles up as a poster, which is inside as well. And you get a gold foil bookplate autographed by the author illustrator, which is Kari Fry. And yeah, this was only, like I said, this was printed and bound in the USA only. So yeah, so like I said, this has loads of illustrations in it. It tells you, it's so in depth, it's hard to explain. It's about everything. Everything about Zelda, everything you can possibly understand or even comprehend. It's basically illustrations of every race, universe, myths, you know, items, weapons, relics, creatures, rulers, guardians, maps, everything in this book. If you want to know anything about Zelda, this is the most detailed and excellent book to go for if you want to know everything about Zelda, The Legend of Zelda, Hero, and Link. So without further ado, guys, I'm going to show you the extras you get with the special edition, which is a special edition. I'll show you guys the actual real cover of it. You get yourself a nice Triforce pin badge, which is only exclusive, so this is like really rare. You get yourself another Zelda like sticker. This is a sticker you get, which is quite awesome. This is the gold plate signed by the Miss Kari Fry, which is, that's her signature there, so that's really awesome. Got some Hyrulean writing there, which is quite cool. Okay, you also get a nice little certificate as well for ordering the special edition, and it has my name there as well, and it's like a little joke, so that's pretty cool. And they all, that all comes in a little bag here, so it's not like in bits or anything. So yeah, without further ado, I'll actually show you guys the book itself. So as you can see, we have front cover here. It has all this amazing texture and different images here. As you can see, you've got familiar faces in the background or creatures that you might know of. You've got a few other things down here. On the side, it just has the name, Legend of the Hero, the book, and a nice sort of gold line going down here with a Triforce at each end. On the back, it just tells you about everything, which is basically, if you guys want to read that, pause the video. Yeah, this is a guide. It says here, this is a guide to over 80 common ingredients, beings, catalogue of relics, artifacts in the land of folklores, heroes, beasts, and a demon king. It has an index of so many native peoples and their culture, and geographical survey of the land over time. So yeah, mouthful. Okay, so taking the actual cover off now, which I'm just gonna move the camera so you guys can see. So this is what you guys will be getting as a special edition. Now this is the actual leather part of it. And as you can see, it's really nicely detailed. You've got Hyrulean writing here, and here you have a sort of a master sword in the middle of a Z, which stands for Zelda, I gathered. On the side, which is some beautiful Hyrulean writing here. Camera can just focus and show you guys that. You have Triforce pieces at the top there. And see, you've got a nice gold frame going all around the book, which is really gorgeous. And the texture in this book is awesome. And you've got another Triforce there. Trifle shards and pieces. Okay, so moving in from the actual book itself, you get a beautiful rich, if I just give you guys a bit of a zoom there, rich paper here they use, which is really nice. Going into the contents now, you've got a nice C there of the sword, same as the front cover. Now obviously you guys won't be able to see all this properly, but says there, basically, in this area here, you have it. It says, first edition, Legend of the Hero, has the contributors and the special thanks section. I guess I can try and zoom in on that. Give it. I think you guys can read that and the names. There we go. So they're the names that are involved of the making of this book, and obviously a lot more other things. So, let's just shut you down because you're making a nasty effect. So, continue with the book now. We have just saying what it's about and everything. And we have the table of contents. Now, if I just zoom on this a little bit, to show you guys this awesomeness. So this is what the book covers. So basically you have and it focuses. Basically what this book covers is you got the let's have a look. So we have you got flora and fauna and friends. Then you have relics and artifacts, historic feats and courage, spirits and guardians, races and cultures, the shifting landscape, music and time. So as you can tell, it's 220 pages long. Okay, so the game here, we've got a nice sort of dragony, got the dragon bird things here, Hyrulean writing. Now I will show you what I'm going to show. I will show you guys this this entire book. It's going to be a long review, guys, but it's going to be worth it. Trust me. If you guys want to even considering buying this, and you're a UK person like me, and you want to buy this Zelda book, you're a massive Zelda fan. You want to know what this book is all about, so this is what this review is going to show you guys. So basically this here is just the book about friends of Link and Zelda. You have mammals here, so there you got mammals there. Okay, so now we move on to enemies. So as you can see, you've got the strong warrior bulldog, strong warrior hog, got a menial soldier horned, and you've got standing goats swarming, apparently. So basically, what the information here is you've got Hyrulean writing here as a title, and then in English, the real what they are, and then every character or enemy has their own, like, as it says here, you have like appearance, behavior, habitat, even to the dead diet, approach, and notes, and how much of a threat they are in the Legend of Zelda world. So it's actually, that's how in depth this book is, and I know I said I will show you guys every page, but this is going to be a long review, so I'm going to have to sort of just basically show you guys the art inside and the monsters and whatnot, and then we'll just sort of see how we go with the review. This could be a long review. So I just have a few enemies here that Link faces. Now these guys were in Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, I believe. And yeah, they were a pain in the ass to fight. Got some reptiles here. Some more different creatures you encounter in all the Legend of Zelda games. A few of them you'll notice, and a few of them you won't. Even got birds here. Birds of the Hyrulean. Quite intense. You have a false bird, talon headed, which is, I believe, what game they're in, I can't remember now. I believe these were in Wind Waker. In a few other Zelda games, I've appeared in before. Majora's Mask and Link to the Past and all the other games and whatnot. As you can see, the beautiful artwork this book really excels in. Absolutely phenomenal, just absolutely fantastic. A few of the enemies you may recognise here, which are quite annoying. Few spiders. Got a few of the bosses there. That isn't a boss, but that is. Invertebrates now. Octopuses. Some jellyfish and some clams. All water life enemies. A few fish and enemies. So this is how in depth this book is. It just goes through every single enemy and feature in the games that have been released before. It's just such a mouthful. It's such a, you know, you're gonna have to take quite a few hours to read this book, or even days, the way this is. I mean, you will not have time to wash, eat, drink or anything to read this damn book. This book is so much detail, it's just unreal. I'm going as quick as I can, guys. You can skip the video if you want. Just do skip to a part where you may be more interested in. I don't know, some people are more interested in things than other. So, here we are at relics and artifacts. Now, as you can see on the left-hand side, you have some nice symbols here of the icons you use during the games and the relics and whatnot and artifacts and everything else. So, yeah, see here. Right, so we have healing items. So as you can see down here, you have the what the potions do and everything. Just amazing detail from top to bottom. Absolutely awesome. You have even currency, which we all know they're called rupees. Different type of rupees there. It tells you what the pouches are about and how they're used and whatnot in the game. Then you have tools here. You have a list of tools which you use in the games you've played and series. show you guys the list of that. And obviously a close-up of the instruments that you use, the tools. Quite awesome. Okay, now moving on. Have the different types of swords that Link has used during his adventures. Got a couple of different types of master swords here, it's quite funny. Just do a little detail up on that. Really cool. Give you the name of the swords there that he's used. Okay, so I'm not familiar with some of these, but I am familiar with other ones. So you even get different types of arrows used. Link has used. You've got a normal arrow here, flame arrow. Then you have the frost arrow, explosive arrow, silver arrow, and holy arrow, which you fight Ganondorf with a few times. Have different types of bombs. Powder keg apparently. I skipped a page. You have various types of shields Link has used during his past battles. Sacred relics. There's all sorts going on there. Different types of armor Link has used. You've got the famous green basic tunic he uses. You've got the red version there, and you've got blue warrior's armor. Then it goes on to more of the attires he's used, more of the basic attires he's used before going to the main game. Sort of like a prologue attire, if you will. So you've got the goat herder guard, you've got the islander guard, and you've got skytrap guard. Garb, should say. Okay, so let's moving on. We have wearable tools which he uses throughout the game. Got the power glove, the mole mitts, the diver's flippers, iron boots, the strength bracelet, and the Pegasus boots. Then you have different types of masks here. You've got the truth, you've got the kitsune mask, mischief mask, warrior god mask, sea folk mask, woodkin mask, and the mountain folk mask. So very interesting. Then these are the things that these sort of people use. So this is the instruments they'll use. Okay, then you've got dungeon items, which we all know what they're about. You've got the boss key, you've got the map, and then you've got the big boss chest. Big chest, as it calls it in the game. Okay, so historic facts of courage, feats of courage. So this section is basically about all the artwork of the bosses and enemies in one. So I'm sure you guys would like to see this. A bit more closer with this, if the light would stop going on the damn book. So this is going to take a little bit of time, so I'm just going to flick through quickly, guys, and show you the... awesomeness. Got the millipede there, genie. Different enemies there, different coloured pages. You got the jungle warrior there, you got a mythical beast, monster fish, twin centipede, spirit of the mask. Here we have the armored lava centipede, you have the parasitic plant, ancient apparatus, brutish helmet bird, spectator, burrowing worm, Grant's forming beast puppet, and the demon king, which we all know who that is. And that is none other than Ganondorf. Okay, so give you a closer look at Ganondorf. Okie dokie. So, moving on. Other bosses here. And we come to the last page of bosses. It's the ancient scorpion, molted fiend, golden amaturn, parasitic growth, sea terror, the demon prisoner, the dark servant, and the demon. So we have all sorts there. Okay, so the next chapter. Spirits and Guardians. Okay, so Spirits and Guardians. So some of you guys, if you're a massive fan, you'll know all these. These are the three goddesses. Next one is the Windfish, which you guys will be familiar with. Next one is the Fairy and the Great Fairy, which we've seen multiple times when we've asked for help in the game at certain points. The Three Dragons. You've got the Four Giants, Four Ankles. Got the Frog Brothers of the Wind, which we see these in Wind Waker. They help you out and learn new tunes to get through the game. You've got the Sky Spirit, which I recognise him in Wind Waker. You've got the Dooku Tree, but it's called here the Great Spirit Tree. And you've got the Fish Lord Jabu. Wise Owl Sage. The Great Sky Guardians, Lord Horse Guardian, Loyal Horse Guardian should say, and we got the Animal Companion Trio. So right, so these will be, the next chapter will be rules, races and culture. So basically this is what we're going to show you. So here we have the Highland people. These are basically common. These are basically the rich folk of the Legend of Zelda fan. And these are the bits they've used. This is like related to them. And you've got all sorts of pots here. Pottery, milk containers. Just basic things that these people would use, really, in their culture and whatnot. Relics they'd use. I think I skipped it. No, I didn't. Okay, you've got the Sky Tribe relics. Got the Islander relics. You've got Sea Folk. Sea Folk relics, which are obviously related to them. It's quite cool. Got the River Folk. And the stuff they use as well. Basically just fish stuff. We have the Bird Folk, which I do believe we met these in the Wind Waker. And this is the stuff they use from their ancient relics. These are the Mountain Folk, which are the Gorgons. Gorons, should I say. There's the stuff they use, called Mountain Folk. Well, funny name. Okay, so we have the Woodkin Folk and the relics they would use. And here we have the Children of the Forest, a little bit like a young version of Link, or his siblings of perhaps, I don't know. It's the stuff they'll be using, and this looks like very familiar. It's the Orokina, I should say, which they play the music from. And you've got the Spirits of the Forest, you know, you've got the usual ones from Wind Waker which you guys would recognise. And you have the relics that they would use and the stuff that you would use on your journeys. You've got the Helicopter Seeds, you've got Seed of the Great Tree, you have the Barber Seed, and then you have the Cauldron, which you make different potions from, I believe. Now then, you've got the Shadow Tribe. Now, if you're a Zelda fan, you know who this is. This is actually, or spoiler alert, if you don't know anything, turn off the video right now if you don't know what I'm talking about, if you don't want to spoil this. This is Princess Zelda undercover, basically. So, yeah. Okay, and now you've got Shadow Tribe relics, which they use. Now then, this is what I found really interesting. More interesting than others. Now, we all know who this guy is here. That's Ganondorf. Now, what I've learned, he is from the Desert Clan, and apparently this is what it says on the description here. It says, the olive-skinned people of the desert. Unlike most of the people of the land, their ears are short and length and rounded. Their noses, however, are long and pointed. Their eyes are strikingly gold-blued. Okay, so their civilization is almost entirely female, with only a single male known to be born every 100 years. So Ganondorf is the only known male of the Desert Clan alive, as of now. With only a single male known to be born every 100 years. So according to their precepts, this male is to be unquestionably reserved as a king. So this guy's a king, which I didn't even know that. These are very capable people, advanced enough to build momentous structures that celebrate their duty and the sand goddess. Not much is known for their society, since they are generally secretive and inhospitable to outsiders. Researchers have attempted to study their culture and have been captured and kept in solitary confinement. So these guys aren't friendly, and they are very highly intelligent. So this is stuff these guys would use. Obviously Ganondorf and his wife, by looks of his mother. Okay, so this is obviously going to be the art of the lands that you discover along the games. So we see here we have the Sky Kingdom, which is quite awesome. Next one is the World of Light Kingdom, which is quite awesome. And here we have the World of Darkness, which I do believe when I was playing Hyrule Warriors, I actually went through these couple of lands, which I do recognise now. Okay, next one is the Royal Highlands. I'm guessing it belongs to the kingdom, the king and queen of Hyrule, whoever they are. Slay Zelda, princess. So here we have the Moon's Cradle. So this is, you guys know who this guy is. He's from Wind Waker, Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. And he's Mr. Tingle, and apparently this must be his land then. Or you must live in this land or whatever, so yeah. Next one is the Great Sea. Now this is basically the Wind Waker's map. If you've played this, you'll know, you'll recognise it straight away. You have this sea creature here, which helps you pinpoint maps in your location and makes you relatively aware of what places you can visit now. And you didn't know that was on the map before. And here are the Orokina's tunes you can play to control the weather and different time and different powers. And here's obviously the Wind Waker's tune, which you use Wind Waker for. You've got the Winds Rockorum there, you've got the Ballad of Gales, Ballad of the Earth, Arena of the Winds, and Passing Song, and Melody of Command. So that is really awesome. I didn't expect that to be in there. And here's some more. Well, I can't even read this, so I ain't got a clue what the hell this is. So this is all in Hyrulean writing, so I don't know. But there's some interesting pictures there, nonetheless. I'm actually having a guess here. This is actually the timeline of the games, by the looks of it. Anyway. So that is actually about it for this book, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed looking at this book. It is damn worth buying this. Even if you're in the UK and you think, I'm not going to hit with custom charges. Well, actually, these guys actually make sure you don't get hit with custom charges. Thanks to a person on Facebook which I spoke to about this custom charges. So yeah, this book is absolutely fantastic. I highly recommend it for all Legend of Zelda fans. This is a fantastic book and should be bought. This is going to be really rare and really hard to get hold of soon, so I would move your butts and try and get it. Now, what I didn't show you guys before I end this review, I need to show you guys the inside of the cover of the red case. So this is the casing over the book, and inside, which I showed you guys before, is actual artwork. So if I just show you guys quickly that. You've got the Orokina there, you've got all different, these are all different tools and weapons and whatnot that Link has used on his travels and journeys and adventures. So yeah, that's what's inside. So yeah, like I said guys, I do highly recommend this. I think you should definitely get this. This is a fantastic book to read. I've really enjoyed going through this with you guys, and it's just fantastic. So yeah, 100% recommend for all you Legend of Zelda fans. So yeah, thanks for watching guys. Leave a comment down below, thumbs up, and subscribe if you haven't already.